Ελληνοτουρκικά και Ερντογάν, γεωπολιτικές προκλήσεις στην Ανατολική Μεσόγειο, Ηνωμένες Πολιτείες και Ρωσία, αλλά και η στενή στρατηγική συνεργασία Ελλάδας, Κύπρου, Ισραήλ. Αυτά συζητάμε με τον δόκτορα Εραν Λέρμαν, ο οποίος είχε επί χρόνια υπηρετήσει στο Συμβούλιο Εθνικής Ασφαλείας του Ισραήλ στο γραφείο του Πρωθυπουργού Νετανιάχου και τώρα διδάσκει στο Κολέγιο Σάλεμ της Ιερουσαλήμ. Dr. Lerman, thank you very much for being here with us today, and let me start with this. Hardly a day goes by without a source of conflict between Greece and Turkey. War of words, the two Greek military officers are still being detained. Constant incidents in the Aegean, also a lot of tension with Cyprus over natural gas search. What to expect in the coming months?
Well, clearly this is part of a broader pattern of ambitions that President or Sultan Erdogan is playing up to some extent for internal domestic reasons, but also because he feels that he now has a very broad mandate to reassert Turkish power in the Eastern Mediterranean, in what used to be called the Middle East, and beyond. He has very far-reaching ambitions, and I think he's playing a dangerous game. At the end of the day, this is not just your soldier, officer and sergeant who were essentially abducted. It is not just the provocations of the Aegean. He has expressed an interest in reopening Lausanne. These are dangerous tendencies. We are in Israel, we are familiar with his ambitions. We see the brutality of his actions in northern Syria recently. So yes, we are in a dangerous passage, not hopeless, because I think there are tools of pressure that can be brought to bear. I think Turkey, at the end of the day, is a member of NATO, and NATO is still relevant to Erdogan, is relevant to Erdogan's military. There's no procedure for throwing out a NATO member, even if this member works with Iran, buys Russian goods, and harbors terrorists. But there are ways of limiting the capacity of a member state to participate in NATO activities. I think pressure can be brought to bear. The U.S. Congress, I think, and I wrote so recently in public, so I believe that this should and needs to be done, should raise questions about the F-35 deal with Turkey. The Americans can bring pressure to bear. The new incoming team of Bolton and Pompeo and Gina Haspel, three very tough individuals who can have a straightforward conversation with the Turks. So, and at the end of the day, about half of Turkey is not with Erdogan. The ability of Erdogan to build his base rests on what he did for a huge number of lower class, poor people who moved into the lower middle class through the economic growth of Turkey. All of this can be endangered if the Turkish economy begins to pay the price for Turkish ambitions. And so I think there is a ceiling. He hasn't hit that ceiling yet. And perhaps it's time for Turkey's NATO allies to bring the ceiling a bit lower before he makes more mistakes.
As far as it concerns the deeply strained Greek-Turkish relations, how far can Erdogan go, you think? U.S. ambassador to Greece, among others, has already expressed fears of an accident between Greece and Turkey in the Aegean.
Well, I certainly think that you should use the NATO channels to build up a CBM, confidence-building measure or tension reduction mechanism. And I'd certainly, because when tensions grow high, the smallest incident can escalate. And nobody wants that. I don't even think the Turks really want that. But you have to be on a higher level of readiness. And all of us in the Eastern Mediterranean working together should be better prepared to contain the possibility of Turkey, the possible Turkish ambitions. The Americans... they're not easy to rely on nowadays, but at least they have taken a position on the right of the Cypriots to drill in their own EEZ. I think that's an encouraging sign.
Yeah, but at the same time, they are reducing their presence in the region while Russia expands its own. And as far as it concerns Syria, it seems that Turkey, Iran, and Russia hold the cards there. What is your interpretation of the situation?
Well, I'm very worried about the recent statements of President Trump about leaving Syria. I hope he is open to reconsideration. I hope the new team, which is not yet in place, they are only coming in the next few weeks, Pompeo and as Secretary of State and Bolton as National Security Advisor, will give him a sense of the consequences of abdicating and particularly of betraying the Kurds and the SDF. But if that happens, I think we should count on the inner contradictions between the Russian and Turkish positions to come to the surface relatively quickly. The Russians do not oppose to a Kurdish presence. The Russians have a strong and long held position on Greece and Cyprus, supporting Greece and Cyprus. When I had conversations with Russian officials about the vision of a Mediterranean cooperation, their reactions were always positive. And so we need to keep our channels open with the Russians. I know that's not easy these days against the script, the background of the British crisis and the Skripal case, but we, Israel and Jerusalem and Athens, should keep channels to Moscow open against the future possibilities.
Let us talk a little bit about the dynamics in the Eastern Mediterranean. In your papers, you use the term camp of stability in the region. There is the Greek Cypriot Israeli strategic cooperation. Will you put all this in context?
Well, this is part of a larger system because Greece and Cyprus are also having the same type of tripartite dialogue with President Sisi in Egypt, who just got re-elected with 97% of the vote. That doesn't make me happy, but it's a fact of life. I mean, the number, I'm glad he's there. I'm not glad about the numbers. They indicate a slide in the wrong direction. But at the end of the day, he is there and we need his help and support in fighting off the various Islamist challenges. Jordan is also part of this system. There was a tripartite meeting in Nicosia earlier this year. And if, and that's a big if nowadays, Italy can put its house together after the recent elections and sustain a coherent and forward-looking strategy, between us, our six nations have a vested interest in the stabilization of the region, in holding off Turkish ambitions, in defeating Islamist terrorists, and in blocking the ambitions of Iran to gain a foothold on the Mediterranean. We face challenges in common, and we need to get closer and closer together, possibly even creating a regional forum for security cooperation, like the one that's already existing in the Western Mediterranean, the 5+5.
Let us go back to the Greek-Turkish relations. What do you think will happen with the two Greek military officers whom Erdogan links with the eight Turkish officers seeking asylum in Greece?
Well, I would say that for a member of NATO, which seeks a normal place in the community of nations to behave like a band of robbers, is dangerous and should not be accepted as normative behavior. In any case, I understand that the decision not to extradite came from the Greek courts, so I don't know how that can be circumvented. I would use every channel possible to put maximum pressure for these two lost souls who I understand got lost in the woods in a winter day to be retrieved. I don't think the Turks can play this kind of game for long. Yeah, this is playing to the galleries. And clearly, it's the same as he also threatened the United States if the US will not extradite Gulen. But at the end of the day, there's a limit to how far he can take this kind of behavior.
Is it possible, you think, these eight Turkish officers to have the same end as those six in Kosovo when they are released from prison?
I would recommend that if they leave Greece, they should leave to a country where the long arm of Hakan Fidan does not necessarily reach. Kosovo definitely is rife with Turkish penetration, as is the case, I believe, in most of the Muslim areas of the Balkans. I would take them a bit further. But in any case, and I know that quite a lot of Turkish expatriates now live in fear. Everyone, I would say that at the age of five, walked on the pavement next to a Gulen kindergarten, is by now a suspect in the eyes of the present government. I think this is intolerable behavior, and I think that, as I said, tools of pressure should be brought to bear on Turkey to put an end to this.